Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-365. If you're looking to standardize your Microsoft 365 security baselines across a framework and don't know where to start, stay tuned because in this video, I'm going to show you a new self-assessment that I built that you can get, which allows you to perform a self-assessment against the CIS controls. And I think this is really important because it helps you understand, number one, what to go prioritize, but also your gaps today, maybe in your cybersecurity compliance, and just your risk overall, maybe in your Microsoft tenant, as well as the downstream customer tenants that you manage. So we're working through all that, including a Power BI template that I built that allows you to help track this across your customers over time. As always, if this content's helpful, go ahead and like and subscribe. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, so I've talked about in the past how I think MSPs do a really good job about creating checklists, SOPs for onboarding customers into Microsoft, but not a lot of us follow a certain compliance framework or have that North Star for the things that we're doing in the sense of the priority or the why behind while we're implementing these checklists. So wanted to build these templates out here. I've done one for NIST 2.0. This one is for the CIS controls. And this is simply saying that you can perform a self-assessment based off of your business practices today and what you've implemented. So this free self-assessment that I'll link below that'll be part of my blog on this is really just saying, hey, we have this basic scoring system. It's 1 through 4. And you're to go and self-rank yourself across the CIS 18. And the basic premise here is that either you're not doing this at all today, or you, on the opposite end, have this fully automated, have it fully reported, and there's a formal review process in place. So you can make judgment calls on that, but effectively you're using this self-assessment sheet here to run through the CIS 18. And when you do, you know, this particular radar chart will be updating based off of not only where you're at today as far as the score goes, but then your 6-month target, 12-month target, and then your ultimate goal score, which should be, you know, kind of like that full automation, full review, formal review process as well. So you can run through this and kind of just self-assess your MSP practice, and you can do this across your customers as well too, and I'll be showing you that. That's what you can actually use with the Power BI template that I built as well, just to run through and say, hey, this is where you're at today, this is where we want to be, and then you're also documenting any type of deviations, exclusions to your policies, things like that. It's a really organized way to assess this. One thing that I love though with the CIS controls is that they have these implementation groups, and the implementation groups here are really just saying, like, we're putting these controls in 3 major buckets, and that's across all of the safeguards that are part of the CIS controls, and it gives you a great way to have a starting point. So it can be often very overwhelming to think about all these various safeguards, or if you map this like I have to Microsoft, I've got about almost 200 controls here that you can go and implement in the Microsoft tenant, or practices you can implement. And that's very overwhelming to think about, and especially doing that across your customers. So one big goal that you might want to have is just simply saying, I want to get IG1, implementation group 1, done across all of my customers. And you can do that here, you know, with this self-assessment. This tab though is where, again, I've mapped the Microsoft standards or Microsoft controls across the Microsoft suite of offerings like Entra and Teams and Exchange and Intune. And I include things like the base licensing requirement that you'll need for that. Now, this is granular in the sense that it is the high-level base bucket, you know, for business licensing, enterprise licensing. You can't all use the maps resource there to get the exact mappings of individual licenses there. But I meant for this to be a track for you to say, hey, what kind of status are we in on these, and what target and current scores do we have for ourselves using that same scoring system there? So I have these in there. You can certainly modify this to what you guys would want to use, but I felt like this was a good progression in the sense that maybe we just have a policy written behind this, but we haven't implemented it in our organization or in the customer organization if we're doing this assessment on behalf of a customer. The basic premise here though, I also have a tab for, you know, just the CIS 18 and kind of mapping that in a different view. So you can see how I've done, you know, kind of the mappings to all the controls and safeguards. And then this one is something that you don't really need to modify outside of if you're doing it for a client and the assessment date. But effectively here, you're just getting the summaries that are coming from what you're doing in the self-assessments. So we can have this as a roll-up. And a lot of this is what I built to help you look at the Power BI templates as well too. So this will automatically calculate a recommended tier for you as well. And I put that in. I think with CIS, it's a little bit different than I did with NIST, given that the implementation groups give you a lot of this. But I also wanted to say, you know, given your time and resource constraints, here's kind of your tier based off of what you scored. And that's what you would want to start with first in trying to implement all those controls and then step your way up. And in the Microsoft world, you know, that's going from things like, you know, basic configurations that don't really affect end users that much, but provide us good security, to the more blanket level changes that require stricter and stricter requirements, maybe affect end users more. And a lot of that I've outlined here with the impact scores as well too. So once you go through that free assessment, if you think that's valuable, I've also created more of the paid offering, which is this enablement ebook along with Power BI templates you can use that are both multi-tenant and single tenant capable. And this I've been having for a very long time. This is the most updated version of this, but it basically takes all those controls that I'm recommending in there, and I give you kind of all the enablement content. So what's your policy definition? What CIS control does it map to? What licensing considerations that you need to have? What are the setup instructions? Any PowerShell scripts, video tutorials that will help out here as well. So just kind of fully baked as far as just a general understanding, and this will help you with the rollout over time, and maybe with the PowerShell scripts, kind of getting into some of that automation capabilities as well. I don't have that for every single control, obviously, but this gives you a lot of the enablement content that you'll get stood up. And then from there, this is the Power BI template that I built as well too, which you can see is both multi-tenant, single tenant capable. If you're watching this under just a single tenant, I have a Power BI template for that as well that doesn't include this tab. But effectively here, you know, it's allowing you to visualize, you know, after you run these assessments in your customers, the controls, and you have some slicers, you know, for saying, hey, I just want to see what we're looking at across IG1, you know, and we'll have our percentages there, and we'll have the percentages against, you know, all of our customers kind of running through here as well too. Then maybe you want to say, I only want to look for control 6, which is access control management. That'll go ahead and update these, and you'll see your IG1 bumped up to 94%. And I can see my IG1 implementation through IG3 across customers. And then the subsequent cards are updating as well too. So if I back out of that and just scroll down, I have kind of your current and target scores based off of the Microsoft suite offerings. So you can see kind of your maturity level against the different offerings from Microsoft like Intune and Exchange. Subsequently, the categorization of those as well too, just kind of a visual play across all customers to say, you know, do we need to mature in our, you know, application security as an example of that, and where do we want to be? And then this is kind of more of that radar chart against all customers via, you know, the CIS controls, and this is your target scores versus your current scores, and that includes a 6-month and 12-month target. So again, you can see here, I'm a little bit weaker, maybe in penetration testing, incident response management, access control. Penetration testing for MSPs obviously is going to be something that's more common, that we're not mature in that area. We don't do that very often today. But these other ones here, like data protection, for instance, is something that, you know, maybe weaker on, but we really need to improve that. I only have 3 customers in this test space, but you know, you can scale this out with different customers as well. This is kind of a heat map of your IG1 implementation, so you can quickly just maybe peruse and scan and see which one of my customers is kind of weak in IG1 really quickly, just to kind of scan your environment. The same thing is true with your profile scores over time. I don't know that you'd be able to do these assessments on your customers every month, but maybe every quarter, maybe every 6 months, even once a year to start, honestly, if you're not starting from anywhere, is a great place to be. And just so you can track that over time. And this last one here is just kind of like mapping this in a different way with a scatter plot, which allows you to see, you know, a maturity level here, which is saying that if my customers are up far to the right on the top of the list, means they have much more maturity when it comes to the CIS controls versus somebody who's over here to the left and in the bottom quadrant, really, if you will. So just another way to visualize this, to quickly see this across your customers. And the single tenant is really the same. You can select a tenant in your environment that you want to peruse and see kind of where they're at. And similar functionality here as far as being able to kind of drill into, you know, individual controls and safeguards. You can see in this case though, if I back out of this, you can see in this case kind of your implementation for your Microsoft policies across all of the different controls as well too. You can see which ones are automated, which ones you have in progress. So clearly, like, you know, data recovery, malware defenses kind of stand out to me really immediately, just on things that maybe I need to, you know, go ahead and start to improve upon with this customer. Similar maps here as far as radar charts. But then I've taken, you know, that list of services that you saw or security baselines from Microsoft, and you can go ahead and say, well, I want the base license requirement to at least include business premium, level of effort, user impact. I can modify these as well too. And again, if I go into like IG1 and I want to say data protection is what I want to view, all the controls down here are classified or modified and filtered to that set. So it's a great way to kind of track this in a visually appealing way, better than a spreadsheet. You are still using the spreadsheet, obviously, right now for these overall assessments, but this is just another way that you can track this as well too. To set this up, let's go ahead and pivot into Power BI so I can show you that as well. So if you were to get this, you'll have a setup guide and instructions on how to do this, but whenever you open one of these templates, you'll get prompted to put in a file path. And if this is the multi-tenant one, you'll put in a file path as a folder with all of your sample customer data in it. So to show that here, let me pop up my Windows Explorer. In this case, I've just created this folder called CIS Sample Customers, and this is where I put all of my assessments. And again, these are labeled by customer name on the inside and the date in which I'm, you know, performing the assessment, just so we can see that kind of fold through. And then again, back in the report here, you'll get prompted to put in the file path of the folder that these are in. And the same is true on a single tenant one. You'll be asked to just put in the file path of the actual CSV file or Excel file that you need. If you don't see that though, or if you get an error message, you can go up to this transform data, which will open up this Power Query editor. And in the Power Query editor, you'll have this folder path name. And this is, again, you want the full path of where that's located. And you can just put that in, and I have my CS sample customers, and you can hit close and apply, and that will apply your data to this model. The other good news is that, you know, you can customize this. You don't want to change any of the names of the columns that I already have in there, but you can modify it even further or change, you know, other components of it here as well too, if you want to customize it even more for your business. Lastly here, I've been building this tool here, which is an automated self-assessment tool for Microsoft. And it basically goes in and it's saying, hey, I'm going to grab all of the security configurations and kind of some of the things that you have set up in the tenant, and I'm going to run an automated pass-fail against CIS. So you can sign up here for free and you can run a tenant for free. But you'll notice here, you know, within the portal, you can see kind of a list of the tenants that I already have, and you can choose to just add a tenant by adding a domain name and clicking run the report. You'll consent to the permissions, and this will spit out this PDF in just a few minutes. This is an example of the PDF that it spits out here. It's got a lot of data, but again, I'm automating the pass-fail values of what I can, at least for the CIS 18, and this is kind of showing you kind of more of an executive summary of that. But I have a list of all the pass-fail values for the CIS controls. And this gets into a lot of data that I'm not going to cover in this video. But effectively here, I'm looking for things like your security license utilization, things like MFA adoption, multi-factor authentication methods that are weak or strong, device health, really, mail health for the things that you have set up as well there too. And then this is where you get into the pass-fail values of the CIS controls with actual evidence from the tenant that shows, yeah, we've passed this control as it relates to, you know, the CIS or Microsoft 365 baseline. So that goes across, you know, again, all the CIS baselines. And then in the back of the section here, after you get through all that, this is where I have the evidence as well too. And this goes beyond even just the CIS controls to look at things in this case like licensing, where you have lack of consumption, you have your NCE renewal dates, and then you have things that are pretty, you know, alarming or something you would want to go take care of, like MFA registration. In this case, we're looking at, you know, people who are licensed that aren't covered by conditional access or security defaults, their accounts enabled, they're a user, they're not a shared mailbox, and they still have that going on. So that's just a good example. And then I go across a lot of different data sets, data points, and you know, just things that in my mind you would want to uncover as part of a tenant due to drift, due to misconfiguration, things like that. And this goes beyond, you know, just Entra. It goes into Intune, goes into SharePoint, goes into Teams, and you can see a lot of this data here. So run the free assessment. It's definitely a great tool to check out there. I've been spending a lot of time with it and have a lot of plans for the future. But if you want to get your CIS controls automated as far as the assessment goes, definitely check out that tool. Okay, guys, that's everything I had for you today. Definitely get a copy of that free self-assessment down in the link below on my blog, and check out the Power BI template if you think that would be helpful in helping you track this across your customers. Feel free to leave any comments or questions about anything I covered today. And as always, like and subscribe if you want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. I'll see you guys next week.